Welcome, seekers of truth and wisdom. The path you have embarked upon is indeed a noble one, a quest to unravel the mysteries of the world and to unlock the secrets lying dormant within the folds of spiritual connect. Your curiosity towards spiritual wisdom and knowledge is already an affirmation of the spiritual beings we are. We appreciate your presence here on our channel. Your participation fuels our voyage towards enlightenment. Your support is invaluable to us. We therefore request you to subscribe to our channel for more illuminating and enlightening content. Subscribing to our channel would not just enable us to bring you more enlightening content, it would also empower us to explore the deeper realms of spirituality together, and would also ensure that you do not miss out on any of our enlightening discussions. Through the course of this journey, we'll traverse various landscapes of spiritual knowledge, exploring beliefs, concepts, and theologies from different walks of life. Today's expedition is special. We're about to set foot on sacred ground. The focus of today's exploration is a profound passage from the New Testament, Ephesians 6, verses 10 to 18, often referred to as the armor of God. This passage is a significant part of Christian theology and holds immense value for believers around the globe. The armor of God is an intriguing metaphor used by the Apostle Paul. It beautifully illustrates the spiritual resources that we, as believers, are blessed with to face our spiritual. These battles, though invisible to the naked eye, are as real as the physical world we inhabit. The battles are fought within us, often unnoticed, but their results pervasively influence our lives, shaping our thoughts, actions, and our very existence. As we interpret the armor of God metaphor, you'll realize that it is not just a theoretical concept. It is a practical guide that every believer can employ to understand and deal with the spiritual battles that life throws their way. This passage not only enlightens us about these spiritual resources, but also teaches us how to use them effectively. In order to comprehend the full essence of this passage, we will delve into the historical context of this passage, understanding the time, place, and circumstances that inspired Apostle Paul to use this metaphor. This would provide us with a comprehensive understanding of why it was penned down in the first place and how it seamlessly fits into the larger context of the New Testament. Further, we will unpack the metaphor of the spiritual armor, breaking it down into its constituent elements. We will discuss each piece of the armor in detail, its significance, its symbolic representation, and its spiritual implications. This would enable us to appreciate the depth of wisdom embedded in this metaphor. Moving ahead, we will focus on the practical application of this spiritual in our lives today. It's about how we, as believers, can use this understanding to deal with our spiritual battles and how this armor empowers us to stand firm in our faith. Our journey with the armor of God is not merely academic, it's a deeply personal exploration. As we traverse these verses, we will be uncovering profound wisdom hidden in these metaphors. This wisdom is not just about understanding the Word of God, but about realizing how it applies to our lives, how it resonates with our personal experiences, and how it empowers us to stand firm in our faith, even amidst the trials of life. Our spiritual journey is one filled with discoveries, realizations, and transformations. It is about strengthening our spiritual foundation and enriching our spiritual lives. With every step we take, we draw closer to truth, wisdom, and enlightenment. Now let's embark on this journey of understanding the armor of God. The armor of God, a powerful metaphor used by the Apostle Paul, has its roots deeply embedded in the historical context of the time. To fully comprehend the essence of Paul was conveying, we need to embark on a fascinating journey to the past. Let's step back into the first century, a world distinctly different from what we know today. Picture, if you will, a society punctuated by the domineering rule of the Roman Empire, an era epitomized by unending conquests, pervasive political intrigue, and the ubiquitous presence of Roman soldiers. It was amidst this diverse backdrop that Paul, under the influence of divine inspiration, took up his quill to write his now famous letter to the Ephesians. Transport yourself there. Visualize Paul under house arrest in Rome, sequestered within the confines of a Roman dwelling, observing the Roman soldiers with their impressive, intimidating armor. These soldiers, bedecked in their metal sheaths, were a relentless reminder of the all-encompassing power and supreme authority of Rome. The armor they wore was a formidable symbol of strength, an emblem of protection, and a sign of readiness for battle. With each crevice, each plate, and each strap, the armor represented a soldier's commitment to defend Rome. It's not difficult to piece together how this striking image could have sparked inspiration in Paul's mind, urging him to draw a creative parallel between this physical armor and the spiritual armor that believers need to don in order to withstand the spiritual battles they face. The letter Paul wrote to the Ephesians was not a casual correspondence, nor was it an attempt to merely reiterate religious doctrine. It was a heartfelt plea, a tender message of hope, and a call to spiritual arms. This was an era of immense pressure for the Ephesian Christians. They faced opposition on all sides, from the pagan society around them, from local authorities, and even from within their own ranks. The spiritual conflicts they were engaged in were not metaphorical. They were real, and they were intense. In the midst of their trials and tribulations, Paul's message emerged like a beacon of hope and empowerment. He reminded the Ephesians that their struggle wasn't against their brethren made of flesh and blood, but against unseen spiritual forces of evil. And to stand firm against these malevolent forces, they needed to equip themselves with the full armor of God. The metaphor of the armor of God was not just a literary flourish employed by Paul. It was a strategic and intentional choice, one that carried a profound resonance with the Ephesians. The Ephesians, living under the stronghold of Roman rule, would have been well acquainted with the sight of a Roman soldier and his armor. They understood the purpose and significance of each piece of the armor, and so when Paul drew parallels between the spiritual resources available to them to the various pieces of a Roman soldier's armor, the metaphor came alive. The belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, the shoes of the gospel of peace, the shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit. Each of these elements had a specific role in protecting a Roman soldier during battle. And in a similar vein, each piece of the armor of God represents a different aspect of spiritual preparedness and reliance on God's strength. Paul's choice of metaphor was more than just a brilliant stroke of literary genius, it was also practical. It provided the Ephesians with a vivid and tangible way to understand the spiritual resources available to them. It served as a powerful reminder that they were not alone or defenseless in their spiritual battles. Rather, they were equipped with the armor of God, capable of withstanding any spiritual assault. Understanding this historical context does more than just add color to our interpretation of the armor of God. It allows us to delve beneath the surface of Paul's words and uncover the profound wisdom in his choice of metaphor. It reminds us that the armor of God isn't just an abstract concept, but a practical and powerful tool for spiritual warfare. And most importantly, it reinforces the timeless relevance of Paul's message, reminding us that just as the Ephesians did back then, we too can stand firm in our faith equipped with the armor of God. Each piece of the armor of God symbolizes a unique spiritual resource. Let's dissect them one by one. The first piece of armor Paul mentions in the book of Ephesians is the belt of truth. This is not just a simple belt, but a significant part of a soldier's armor. Just like in the times of biblical warfare, the belt served as the fulcrum, the core support, holding all the other pieces together, keeping them in their rightful places. The belt was the foundation, the starting point, the basis of a soldier's armor. The belt provided stability and balance, a sense of groundedness that prepared the soldier for battles ahead. In parallel, truth is the foundation, the core, the very bedrock of the believer's spiritual armor. It is not just about knowing the truth, acknowledging it, or accepting it. It is far beyond that. It is about living the truth, breathing it, and letting it imbue every act, every thought, and every word. The belt of truth calls us to a higher level of being, to sincerity, integrity, and a steadfast commitment to the truth. This truth is not an abstract concept, but it is embodied in the person and teachings of Jesus Christ. Next, we move to the breastplate of righteousness. The term breastplate might conjure images of an ironclad piece of armor, rigid and impenetrable. A soldier's breastplate was indeed such a shield, a bulwark that protected the vital organs, especially the heart, the lifeline. In the spiritual realm, righteousness serves as our essential defense, our spiritual breastplate. It is what protects our hearts from the assaults, both seen and unseen. This righteousness is not our own. It is not something we can claim credit for. It is the righteousness of Christ imputed to us. This righteousness guards our hearts against the accusations and condemnations of the enemy, constantly reminding us that we are justified in Christ's love and loved by God. The shoes of the gospel of peace come third in this sequence. Just as soldiers needed solid, sturdy footwear to hold their ground, to stand firm or advance into enemy territory, as believers we are gifted the shoes of the gospel of peace. But what is this peace we're talking about? This peace is not the absence of conflict, a serene calm where everything is perfect. No, this peace is the assurance, the certainty of God's love and grace amid life storms, amid the turbulence and trials. The gospel of peace helps us stand firm, rooted and grounded in the face of trials and tribulations, knowing that our ultimate victory is in Christ. It is this sense of peace that keeps us moving forward, steady and unwavering. The fourth piece of the armor is the shield of faith. In battle, a soldier's shield was a vital piece of equipment. It provided broad protection against various attacks: arrows, swords, spears. It was essential for survival. Similarly, our faith, our belief in God and His promises, serves as a shield. It is this faith that protects us from the doubts and fears, the insecurities and anxieties that the enemy throws at us. However, our faith is not a blind belief. It is not a mindless acceptance. It is a confident trust, a firm belief in the character and promises of God. This faith is grounded in His revealed word, the Bible. Then comes the helmet of salvation. This piece of armor, much like a physical helmet, is crucial in protecting the head. But in our spiritual armor, it serves to shield something far more important: our minds. Our minds, where doubts can fester, where fear can take root, and where the enemy often tries to sow seeds of discord. The helmet of salvation is the assurance of our salvation in Christ. It is this assurance that safeguards our thoughts from doubts about God's love and our eternal security. It serves to remind us that we are saved, loved, and belong to God, which is a powerful defense against the lies and deception of the enemy. Finally, we have the sword of the Spirit, the only offensive weapon in the armor. Much like a soldier's sword in the physical world, which was essential for both defense and offense, the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God, serves a dual purpose. The Word of God is not just a collection of words. It is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword. It is a discerning force, able to cut through the facades and discern thoughts and intentions of the heart. By knowing and applying God's word, we are equipped to refute lies with truth, to replace fear with faith, and to overcome evil with good. And let's not forget the call to prayer in verse 18. Prayer is not just a ritual. It is like the life-giving air that fills and empowers every other piece of the armor. Through prayer, we aren't just uttering words, we are actively staying connected to God, tapping into His strength and aligning our hearts with His. Each piece of this divine armor equips us to stand firm in our faith. Whether it's the belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, the shoes of the gospel, the shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, or the sword of the Spirit, each piece is vital. Each part of this armor is crucial and has a unique role to play. Together, they form not just an array, but a complete set of divine resources, empowering us and equipping us to withstand spiritual battles and stand firm in our faith. So let's put on the whole armor of God, stand firm, and fight the good fight of faith. We live in a world full of spiritual battles, so how can we apply the armor of God in our daily lives? Understanding the armor of God requires us to delve into the scriptures, to understand the metaphors and their relevance in our contemporary setting. Just as a soldier wouldn't dare to step into a battlefield without proper armor, we too shouldn't navigate the spiritual challenges of life without our spiritual armor. This armor is not a physical entity, but rather a conceptual framework designed to strengthen our faith and resilience. Now, the concept of the armor of God is far from being just an antiquated metaphor from the Apostle Paul. It's a dynamic, practical guide for leading a life of faith in the 21st century, a time when spiritual struggles are more varied and complex than ever before. It's a blueprint for resilience, constancy, and the audacity to maintain our faith despite all odds. It's a reminder that the spiritual battles we fight aren't aimless, but are an integral part of our journey to salvation. Let's dissect the armor of God piece by piece, layer by layer, to truly grasp its significance. First on the list, the belt of truth. In a world saturated with misinformation, propaganda, and half-baked truths, clinging to the genuine truth of God can often seem like an uphill battle. The belt of truth means seeking God's word for guidance, insight, and discernment. It's about scrutinizing everything against the infallible truth of the gospel, embracing what aligns with it and discarding what doesn't. Furthermore, the belt of truth isn't about passive acceptance. It's about active exploration, engagement, and internalization of the gospel. It's about inculcating a habit of questioning, probing, and investigating to ultimately arrive at God's word. It's about fostering an intimate relationship with the truth rather than simply acknowledging its existence. Next in line, we have the breastplate of righteousness. This is not a testament to our own righteousness, which is often fallible and inconsistent, but rather the righteousness gifted to us through our faith in Christ Jesus. To don the breastplate of righteousness, we strive to lead a life that mirrors Christ's love, compassion, and grace. This means making choices that align with the teachings of the Bible and seeking forgiveness we err. It's about embracing humility, acknowledging our mistakes, and always aspiring towards moral and spiritual growth. The shoes of the gospel of peace, another crucial component of the armor, urge us to walk the path of peace and carry the message of salvation with us in our hearts and minds wherever we tread. To put on these shoes, we strive to coexist peacefully with everyone around us, letting our actions and words reflect the hope and promise of the gospel. It urges us to spread love, kindness, and acceptance, to treat every individual with respect and dignity, and to strive for harmony in our relationships. The shield of faith, with its strong and sturdy demeanor, serves as our defense against the torrents of doubt and fear that often besiege us. In a world that's rife with uncertainties, challenges, and crises, our faith in God's promises provides us with a sense of stability, comfort, and assurance. To lift this shield, we must harbor unwavering trust in God's goodness and sovereignty, even when the circumstances seem dire and hope seems distant. Then we have the helmet of salvation, designed to protect our minds from crippling doubts about our salvation. To wear this helmet, we must constantly remind ourselves of the assurance of our salvation in Christ. This means frequently revisiting the gospel, the promise of eternal life, and engaging in self-reflection and introspection. The sword of the Spirit, which signifies the Word of God, is our sole offensive weapon. It's our means of countering the lies and temptations of the enemy. To wield this sword, we need to immerse ourselves in the study of the Bible, understanding its teachings and internalizing its wisdom. It involves frequent contemplation and meditation on God's Word, thereby fostering spiritual growth and enlightenment. Lastly, Paul makes mention of prayer. Although not a piece of armor, it's the power source that energizes and activates the entire armor. To engage in prayer, we need to maintain a consistent prayer life, praying in the Spirit for a multitude of requests and needs. Prayer is our direct link with God, a sacred time during which we communicate our fears, hopes, and gratitude. The armor of God isn't a relic of the past. It's a timeless resource that empowers us to face today's battles. The armor of God isn't just about surviving life's adversities, it's about thriving amidst them. It's about seeking truth, striving for righteousness, walking in peace, putting our trust in God's promises, guarding our minds, engaging with God's word, and maintaining a robust prayer life. Each piece of the armor serves as a reminder of our dependence on God and the resources He graciously provides to combat our spiritual battles. So let's put on the full armor, stand firm in our faith, and face the challenges of today with the strength and courage that only God can give. The armor of God is more than a metaphor. It's a beacon of light that sheds its radiance on spiritual virtues and resources, illuminating our path as we wage against the glaring darkness of evil. This supernatural armor, as outlined by the Apostle Paul, emboldens us in the face of adversity, serving as a lighthouse of resolve amid the stormy seas of uncertainty. It's a symbol of strength, a clarion call to arms that echoes through the corridors of time, resonating with as much urgency and relevance today as it did in the era of the Ephesians. Paul's message to the Ephesians, and indeed to all of us, is crisp and clear. In our spiritual battles, we are neither alone nor unarmed. Such a profound understanding of Paul's teachings requires delving deeper into the historical context of Ephesians 6:10, 18, the crux of our discussion throughout this video session. In the first century Ephesian society, the armor of God was more than just an abstract metaphor. It was a vivid, concrete image, for they lived in a world where physical armor was not only real, but a common sight. This made Paul's message immediately comprehensible to them. The spiritual battles he spoke of were not about clashing swords or shields in the physical realm, but rather they were about combating forces far more formidable than mere flesh and blood. To better comprehend this, we embarked on a guided dissection of each piece of the armor, each component representing a different facet of spiritual preparedness. The belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, the shoes of the gospel of peace, the shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit. These are not merely symbolic representations. Instead, they are practical tools, each one imbued with divine purpose, designed to equip us for our spiritual journey. Most significantly, we've deliberated on the application of the armor of God in our contemporary world. In an age where battles take on numerous forms, ranging from personal struggles to societal challenges, the relevance and significance of the armor of God cannot be overstated. It's a call to hold fast to our faith, a plea to exhibit strength in the Lord and in His formidable power. As we converge towards the end of this enlightening journey, we recognize that the armor of God transcends the confines of its ancient origins. It's a timeless truth, a spiritual resource that empowers us to confront our battles with unshakable confidence and steadfast courage. It serves as a perpetual reminder that we do not wrestle alone, but with God's infinite strength and power on our side. In essence, the armor of God is an enduring testament to our spiritual resilience and tenacity, a battle gear that equips us with the power to combat today's battles, no matter how fierce or daunting they may be. As we conclude enlightening journey, it is my hope that the lessons learned and the insights gained will go a long way in shaping your spiritual journey. Thank you for joining us on this journey of discovery. If you found this content enlightening, do subscribe to our channel for more. Remember, the armor of God is your untold power for today's battles.